This video will explain what Grasshopper components are and how to use them to build your modeling logic. Grasshopper uses nodes to store data to perform some function or command. The nodes that perform some logic are referred to as components. You can think of components as commands that re-execute every time the input changes. This is why it is critical to verify your input before feeding it into your components. Most components have three parts: the input on the left, the output on the right, and each component embeds some logic that takes the input and produces the output. Anytime the input changes, the component re-execute to produce the new output. There are three main ways to set the input. The first is to type it inside the component itself by right mouse click and fill the corresponding fields. The second way is to supply the input from another component or data node. Every time the logic changes downstream that causes the input to change, it will cause the component to re-execute to generate the new output. The third way to set the input is to reference geometry from Rhino. Again, every time that geometry changes in Rhino, the component re-executes to evaluate the new input and produce a new output. Make sure that you inspect your input before wiring it into any component. The easiest way to do that is to use a panel component. When input changes, the panel updates with the new values, making it easier to follow any changes downstream. The help link inside each component details the input and the output and can serve as a quick reference to each component functionality. For example, if you don't know what the parameters P and R stand for in the circle component, you can right mouse click on the component and that opens the help with the definition of the circle and the details about the input and the output. A good resource to learn about all components and what they do in Grasshopper and how to use them is the Grasshopper Primer and Foundation Manual. There are many other books and tutorials that talk about components and put them in examples. The Rhino website, under Learn and Grasshopper tabs, lists a lot of useful resources, including the primers.